वेलकम टू ई लर्निंग प्रोग्राम ऑफ मॉडर्न इंटरनेशनल स्कूल हिसवा। फ्रेंड्स, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल ऑफ यू। वंस अगेन दिस इज आसिफ फ्रॉम मॉडर्न इंटरनेशनल स्कूल अपीयर बिफोर यू टू डिस्कस एंड अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ होल नंबर्स। दिस इज द थर्ड चैप्टर, होल नंबर्स, क्लास सिक्स। As you know, in the previous video, we have solved some questions. We have solved from question number 1 to 8, just previous exercise. So in this video lecture, first of all, we will discuss about the properties of whole numbers and magic square. Then we will move to solve the questions of exercise 3B. Okay. So friends, let's take started. So here, properties of whole numbers. Properties of whole numbers, the first property is the closure property. It's very simple. Simply we can say the sum of any two whole numbers becomes the whole number. So this is the closure property. As you can see, A and B are two whole numbers, then A plus B is also a whole number. Let us figure out with the help of example. So 2 is a whole number, 7 is also whole number. So 2 plus 7 is equal to 9, means whole number plus whole number is equal to whole number. Once again, whole number plus whole number is equal to whole number. Next, whole number plus whole number is equal to whole number. Once again, whole number plus whole number is equal to whole number. Then we can say the sum of any two whole numbers is always whole number. This is closure property. Now move the next, commutative law. Commutative law properties. Yes, first A and B are two whole numbers. Okay. Then A plus B is equal to B plus A is called commutative law. First see with the help of example. Suppose A is 5 and B is 3. Then find the left hand side. A plus B becomes 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. And right hand side B plus A is equal to 3 plus 5 becomes 8. That means we can say the left hand side is equal to right hand side. And hence this implies A plus B is equal to B plus A. This is commutative law. We can say the whole numbers holds or follows the commutative law on addition. Okay, now see students, next point, additive property of zero. Now see, suppose A is any whole numbers, then A plus zero is equal to zero plus A is equal to A. That means the whole number, or rather we can say if the whole numbers is added to zero, or zero is added to whole number, becomes the whole number. So here with the help of example, see 2 plus 0 is equal to 0 plus 2 becomes 2, 11 plus 0 is equal to 0 plus 11 becomes 11. Okay, now move the next point, associative law. In this law, we need three numbers. Suppose A, B and C are whole numbers, then this implies A plus B close bracket plus C is equal to A separate plus B plus C is the close. Then this is called the associative law. Let us see with the help of example. Suppose A is 2, B is equal to 3 and C is equal to 5. Now first of all, find the left hand side. Okay, here is the A plus B, 2 plus 3 plus 5. Now right hand side, A plus B plus C, 2 plus 3 plus 5. 2 plus 3 becomes 5, here plus 5. So 5 plus 5 is equal to 10. Once again, this is 2 and 3 plus 5 becomes 8. 8 plus 2 is equal to 10. So 10 is equal to 10. That means we can say left hand side is equal to right hand side. Or hence, if A, B, C are three whole numbers, then we can write in such a way, left hand side becomes the right hand side. Then we can say the whole numbers follows commutative, whole number follows associative law on addition. Okay. Now students, next point, magic square. It's very simple, and we can say this simply, magic square is nothing but it is the arrangement of different numbers in a square such that sum of the numbers in every row and sum of the numbers in every columns and sum of the numbers of every diagonals is same. So we will understand this magic square with the help of examples from the exercise. Okay, I hope you will understood orally. Now we will move to solve the questions of exercise 3B. Okay. Now friends, see exercise 3B, question number 1st is here. The question number 1 says, fill in the blanks to make each of the following true statement. Okay, now we have to fill the blanks, okay, to become the true statement. Let us see, here is the 458 plus 639 is equal to 639. So just look at, I have just studied A plus B is equal to B plus A. Have a look, this is called the commutative law. And here the one, suppose A is here and B is here. So B is already is retained. Suppose A is here and B is already retained. That means A should be here. So A is 458. So this is answer by commutative law. Okay, now move the next question. Sub question 5. 5350, this and this. So, and we have to fill this. What number should be filled here? Yes. First of all, think this number is already written here and this number is already here. Okay. Now by associative law, that means one is left. So we have to fill this 799. Okay. This is answer. Yeah. Now next question is question number second says, add the following numbers and check by the reversing the order of the addends. Now see, the first is, what number should be filled? First of all, add the numbers, whatever the numbers is answer. Okay, now move the question number four says, determine each of the sum given below using suitable rearrangement. Here I have taken one sub question of question number 4. If you understand by this question, it will be very easy to solve all the questions. Now see, here is the written 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 96 plus 97 plus 98 plus 99. We have to arrange the numbers so that it will calculate very easily. Okay, so that it's very easy to calculate. Now suppose 1 and 99 can be taken together. 1 plus 9 as 1 plus 99 plus 2 goes for 98, because 2 and 98 will taken together, 2 plus 98, similarly 3 plus 97, similarly 4 plus 96. Why? Because 99 plus 1 becomes 100, 2 plus 98 becomes 100, 3 plus 97 becomes 100, 4 plus 96 is equal to 100. So it will very easy. It is very easy to calculate. Now 100 plus 100 plus 100 plus 100 means 400. This is answer. Okay. We have to arrange the numbers so that the calculation of the given numbers will be easy. Okay. Now, friends, see the next question. Question number 5. Find the sum by short method. Here in question number 5 there are two sub questions, and I have taken one question. Okay, first 6784 plus 9994 times is equal to, now how we can add in short method? First of all, write this number as it is. Okay, 6784, and this is the greatest number of 4 digit. This number can be written as the smallest number of 5 digit or minus 1. Because once 10,000 means 10,000 minus 1, 9,999 can be written as 10,000 minus 1. Okay, so we will take these two numbers together, means 6784 plus 10,000 together, this is minus 1. Now this can be very easy to calculate. Look at, because this is 6784, this becomes 16784, and here is minus 1, here is minus 1. Now we have to subtract 1 from this number, this becomes 16783. This is answer. So how we calculate? It's a very easy way to calculate. Okay, I hope you will get. Now next question, question number 6, have a look. For any whole numbers A, B, C, is it true? Is it true or not? A plus B close plus C is equal to A separate plus C plus B close. Now first of all, see from left hand side, A plus B plus C, if you recollect the points, then you will come to know this is looks like the associative law. Okay, now see, this is left hand side is as it is. This can be written as, where A is separate plus B plus C closed
Okay, so this becomes a plus b plus c, but here is matchless. Okay, now see, so this b plus c can be written as c plus b. Why? Because b and c are whole numbers, and whole numbers hold the commutative law. So this is the commutative law. B plus c can be written as in reverse order, c plus b. So here b plus c is equal to c plus a. Instead of c plus a, we can write down, instead of b plus c, we can write down c plus b. So here is the c plus b. That means a plus b close plus c is equal to a plus c plus b. So yes, it is true. Okay, it is true. Why true? Because we apply the associative law here, and afterwards we apply the commutative law. Okay, here. So this is okay. Now next question. Actually, I talked about the magic square. So here, let us the example from the exercise 7th sub question 1. In magic square, that means there is arrangement of different numbers. In every row, sum of all the numbers is equal, and in every column, okay, sum of all the numbers is also same. Now in every diagonals, here is diagonals, the sum of all numbers in every diagonal is same. Now have a look. We have to fill this box, and this box. First of all, see, here is the numbers 8. First of all, add 8 plus 5 plus 2. This becomes 8 plus 5 plus 2. This becomes 15. Okay, 15. If we add these two numbers, 15 in diagonal. Now 9 plus 2 becomes 11. So what number should be filled here to becomes 15? Yes, here is 4. Okay, now have a look. Because this diagonal, sum of all numbers of this diagonal becomes 15. So what number should we fill here to becomes the 15 in this column? That means 8 plus 4 becomes 12. So the remaining points 3. If 3 is add, then becomes the 15. Okay, now next, have a look. Either this can be observed here, this plus 4 plus 5, 9 plus 6, yes, 15. Okay, now here 3 plus 5, 8. The remaining numbers is 7. 3 plus 5, 8, plus 7 becomes 15. Either we can add every row, you will get the 15, or every column, every sum of all numbers of every column, we will get 15, and every row is also 15. Okay, this is answer. Okay, I hope you will get how to arrange. How to make the magic square? It's very simple. I hope you will understood. So your homework is exercise 3B, question number 1 to 8. Okay, I hope you will understood. Have a nice day.